And we're back, ladies and gentlemen, with Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. I am your host, Chicken Dragon. And last time, we said we were going to do some more fighting in the dueling ring and try to get rid of some of these side quests that we have, of which we do not have many. So, let's go... Ah, where's Karth at?
Ready.
There we go. There he is. Okay. And we're back. Okay. And... Man, just listen to that music.
Real quick.
I know, I go on and on about the music, but it's just so good. It fits. And that's something that you just don't see much these days. Okay, we have 1,412 credits. Let's see. You know what? Let's go back real quick, return to our hideout, upgrade some of our gear, or see what we can upgrade of our gear. Let's see. Armor is... I'm gonna focus on mine since I'm going to be in the dueling ring. Nothing there we can do. Melee. The only thing we can upgrade is that. Okay. Let's check here. Upgrade that. And we can add a scope to it, so we will. Okay. Take Karth. Let's see. Okay, let's see. I wonder what we've got to do to get the Terrace planetary information thing done. Doring and Bendex bounty, that's okay. Ooh, let's talk to Karth real quick. Because you never know.
Yes, what's on your... You do? Well, fair enough. What do you want to discuss?
We didn't finish our conversation last time. I think it's probably the best way to go.
I know you wouldn't understand where I was coming from. Let me try and explain. You got the skills of an elite commando, and you saved my butt more than once. Between that and your facility with languages, I'm lucky you're here. But that doesn't mean that I'm going to stop watching you being wary. I'm just not built that way. Period.
And what exactly are you watching me for?
I don't know that yet. Like I said before, it's probably nothing, but I've been betrayed by people before, and I... Well, it won't happen again. That's all.
So you want some guarantee that I won't betray
you? I don't
know
that you'll betray me, but there are no guarantees. Not for you, not for me. You don't have to take it personally.
I'm beginning to wonder if you're even capable of trusting
anyone. Well, you
can
stop wondering. I'm not.
You sure you don't want to talk about it?
No, I don't want to talk about it. What I want is to save the galaxy, if that's even possible. Why is whether or not I trust you or anyone so damned important to you? Why do you even care? We don't have time for this, so can we please just drop it for now? Can we pick it up later if you really must? I want to get underway.
Okay, fair enough. Check that real quick. Despite being impressed with your abilities, Karth is still not willing to fully open up to you. Maybe if you give him some time, he'll finally learn to trust you. Yeah, maybe. Let's see what he has real quick. See if he has any upgrade materials. Does not seem like he has any upgrade materials. See, what does he have? Light repeating blaster, heavy weapons, no. Blaster pistol. No. Military suit, heavy combat suit. Light battle armor. Well, let's see. I just don't see anything that we really want at the moment. I mean, I see some stuff that would be nice to have, but nothing that's really needed. Just to be sure, we'll check with the lady, Kebla Yurt. We'll check with her real quick, and then we'll go back to the dueling ring, see what we can do there.
Welcome to the Equipment Emporium. Finest selection of supplies in all of Terrace. You interested in...
See what she's got for sale, see if she because has any of the upgrades. She doesn't have any upgrades either. Blaster rifle. Let's see, is there anything I want to sell to her? Clothing. Yeah, we could sell that. We're not going to be using those. I want to keep one just for collection, just because I can. We're going to keep the combat suit because we never know who we might come across that wants that. I'm going to keep the longsword, prototype vibroblade. We're going to sell one of those vibroblades, not the other. We have an extra couple of pistols, so we'll throw those in there. We're going to give Karth that heavy blaster, I think. Yeah, we'll give Karth the heavy blaster. What? Real quick. I'm going to get that heavy blaster there. Yeah. Yeah, definitely. That looks sure. Good. Okay. I wonder if there are any mods that will help the textures. Because that's something that I have been noticing, is that the textures in this game are definitely showing their age. They're still good for the time, but again, showing their age. Okay. Let's see. It sounds like Marl will be our next one, and then Twitch. So let's see what we can do. Yes, I am. Let's do this.
Ladies and gentlemen, draw your eyes to the center ring. We have a very special presentation in store for you. He's a legend in the sport, a 20-year veteran who still knows how to show the young kids a trick or two. Let's have a big hand for...
Mo!
But there's always some young gun coming up to knock the veterans off. And we've got one of the best right here. I give you the Mysterious Stranger.
Yay! Let's send a frag grenade his way. Great. All we wound up doing is making him look cool. Oh, this is not good. Is it cheating to use med packs? I don't know, and I don't care. Because we just beat Marl! Yeah!
The fight is over!
The mysterious stranger has won! Yay!
Down! heads above. Is this the end for the long-time bet? Is it time for Maul to hang up his spurs? And what of the mysterious stranger? Twitch is waiting in the wings. Do you dare take a shot at the champion himself? Will the wild eye wonder finally be unseated?
Okay, sure. Credits. Let's talk tomorrow.
You're good, stranger. Maybe even as good as Bendak in his prime. There's no shame in losing to you. But when you beat me, you made me realize something, kid. First, it was just Twitch I couldn't handle. Now it's you and Twitch. Pretty soon, there'll be another young hotshot clawing past me in the rankings. This game's been good to me, but my time is done. I need to get away from the duel rings for a while. Think things over. Goodbye, stranger. I wish you all the best.
Aww. I really liked Marl. Come on, Marl. Don't do this to me. Don't leave me.
I've never been one to shy away from the cold, hard truth. So I'll just come right out and say it. I can't compete with the likes of you, stranger. I know when I'm overmatched. You're good. Very good. But you're wrong if you think that means I'm suddenly going to warm up to you. Truth is, I really don't have anything more to say. So you might as well move on.
I'm really kind of sad about that. Marl was a cool guy. Favorite side character thus far. Okay. Let's see if I can't get some free healing from Zelka. Then once I go to Zelka, we're going to go back and we're going to fight Twitch and we're going to win. We're going to win for Pete's sake. And then after we win, we're going to kill Bendak. Because we can.
Welcome back. Are you in need of healing or medical supplies? I can treat you right here at the center for almost any condition, except the Rakul disease, of course. It'll just take me a moment while I examine your injuries, and then I'll administer the proper treatment.
Okay. Let's go back and do this. Woohoo! Yeah, I'm thinking next time I level up, which how close to leveling up am I? I'm getting pretty close to leveling up. Next time I level up, I think my next thing is I'm going to go for that dual wielding perk so that I can hit more rather than just sometimes, which is what I have been hitting. So, we'll see how it goes. I'm ready for a duel. Let's fight Twitch.
Okay,
Let's do this.
Ladies and gentlemen, draw your eyes to the center ring. We have a very special presentation in store for you. Hold on to your seats and stay back from the edges of the ring. He's wild, he's unpredictable, he's borderline psychotic. And he's the best damn duelist in the game today. Give it up for Twitch. But Twitch's opponent plans to take the champion down. Night after night, battle after battle, we've watched this young phenom rise through the ranks. In this corner, the challenger for the title of Taris Dueling Champion, the mysterious stranger.
Okay. There's Twitch. I'm gonna throw a couple of frag grenades to start. We're gonna go in here. And we're gonna use the advanced med pack. Get in close. Just be sure. Again, I'm going to use a med pack. Come on, all we need is one good hit. Come on. And again, med pack. And Twitch is getting close. Oh. Oh, goodness. We're so close, ladies and gentlemen. We're almost Harris's new dueling champions. Will we win? Yes, we will, because we will use med packs until we can't. No! Doggone it, Twitch won. Doggone it, Twitch won.
Twitch has done it. Once again, the wild-eyed champion has defended his title. But don't give up, stranger. We all want to see you go after the trap again.
Man. Oh, that was so close. And before you guys start saying, well, he fought cheap. Okay, cheap is laying down mines in the field during the first guys, so that the second, so that the later guys have to run through the minefield to come and get you. Okay, that is cheap. Using med packs is not cheap. Especially since I'm, what, level 5, level 6? I'm level 5 and I still can't beat these guys and I'm using med packs. So, these are guys that you're maybe... that you're pretty much supposed to use med packs on and against.
Welcome back. It would just take me a moment.
I'm going to try one more time. If I can't beat him, then I'll come back. Actually, let me grab a couple of advanced med packs too.
Welcome back.
Because that, if I had used those.
Welcome back. Of course. Just step over here and I'll show you what I have in...
We have enough. We'll buy all of them. Ooh, and he has some implants. Immunity poison. Immunity mind affecting. Ooh. Both of those are nice. Both of those are really nice. Oh, but they're so expensive. So expensive. Does that... I wonder if that prevents you from being stunned, too. Because that would be worth it if that was immunity to stun. Immunity to poison, that could be useful. Side effects include dry mouth. Loss of consciousness due to sudden impact or sensory overload. I think that might be worth it, but I'm not going to get it now. I'm going to wait. I'm close. I'm close to beating Twitch. We're doing good thus far. If I need to, I'll go do some more of the main quest, I guess. Then fight Twitch. But we were doing so good. Oh. And we were so close. He was, all it was one good hit, and we would have had him. Rematch if you want one. What do I say? Give me that rematch! Yes!
Ladies and gentlemen, draw your eyes to the center ring. We have a very special presentation in store for you. Hold on to your seats and stay back from the edges of the ring. He's wild, he's unpredictable, he's borderline psychotic, and he's the best damn duelist in the game today. Give it up for Twitch! But Twitch's opponent plans to take the champion down. Night after night, battle after battle, we've watched this young phenom rise to the ranks. In this corner, the challenger for the title of Taris Dueling Champion, the mysterious stranger.
Good. Okay. And again, we're going to go with our last thing. Ooh, a concussion grenade. We'll see if that helps. Oh, no. Disengage. Dang it. I was not expecting him to go back to hand-to-hand. I was expecting him to start back up. That was a mistake. Okay. We're gonna go for another advanced med pack. Come on! We're so close, so stinking close. No! Oh, got it!
The stranger is down! Oh. The stranger is down! Which has done it! Once again, the wild-eyed champion has defended his title!
Okay. Well, it is going to get expensive to keep buying med packs, so what I think we do is I think we go do some of the other quests. I want to get the Terrace Planetary information out of the way, but I think we're going to have to go down to the Lower City for that. So let's go down to the Lower City. We'll do a little bit more down there. Oh, that burns me up a little bit because we are so stinking close and yet so far. But we will be coming back for Twitch. We will have his head on a pike. Well, maybe not on a pike, but you know what I mean. We will beat the Twitchster. Down with Twitch. Down with him. And, I mean, if we had an unlimited supply of advanced med packs, I totally would. Because just keep grinding until we beat him. But the problem is that if we do that, we're gonna just we're gonna go through and burn through our money trying to get med packs, and that's not a good idea. So we're gonna advance the main quest a little bit, see what we can do. I am gonna save real quick. Give you guys a little bit more exposition before this.
Sorry, but your kind aren't well. Yeah, you do that. Go back to the upper city where your shiny unit.
And then we do this, and we'll see if she changes her tune.
Hey, you can't just walk in here. This is the hidden back base. How do I know you're not a Volker spy sent to kill Gaddon Thek? A lot of people want to go inside and speak to Gaddon. He's a hero of the common folk, but the days of the Hidden Beck's open-door policy are gone. Between the Sith Conquest and the Volker Gang War, Gaddon has more enemies than he used to. We're being careful about who we let in now.
Maybe I could be an ally against all those enemies.
Well, we do need all the help we can get. And you don't look like you're with the Volkers or the Sith. Besides, it's not like you can do anything to harm Gaddon in the heart of his own base. Not with Zerdra watching his back.
So you're gonna let me in?
Go in and speak to Gaddon if you want. Just remember to be on your best behavior. The Hidden Becks are watching you.
I will be on semi-good behavior. Let's get through here. Let's explore a little bit. Let's see what we can explore real quick. Open sesame. Who knows, maybe we can steal some stuff that'll help us against Twitch later.
Didn't work.
Dang it.
Hold it right there. Who are you? And what is your business with Gaddon?
Calm down, Zerdra. Nobody's going to try anything here in the middle of our own base. It would be a suicide mission.
You're too trusting, Gaddon. Brezhik and his Volkers want you dead. Anyone we don't know is a potential threat, and it's my job to make sure you're safe.
Do you want us to start attacking strangers on sight, Zerdra? Like the Volkers do? I will never let it come to that. Now step aside and let them pass.
As you wish. You can speak to Gaddon if you want, but I've got my eye on you. You try anything and you'll be vaporized before you can say Volker spy.
I'm not a Volker spy. I'm a Jedi spy. Only I'm not a Jedi. Somebody's having a dance party.
No problem. Didn't work.
Yeah, feel that groove. Yes, dance. Dance! Okay.
You'll have to forgive Zerdra. Ever since Brezhik and the Volkers began this war against us, she's been a little overzealous in her security duties. The problems with the Sith haven't helped things. Zerdra seems to forget that I know how to look after myself. Now, how can I help you?
First off, you have problems with the Sith.
A foreign army invades Terrace, declares martial law, and locks down all travel to and from the planet? You damn well bet I have a problem with that. If the Sith ever moved in down here, all the swoop gangs would unite against them. We'd use hit-and-run guerrilla tactics to pick them off. Their casualties would be enormous.
Don't fool yourself.
The Sith would never commit to that kind of operation. They'd probably do something much more grand and deadly.
But so far, right. The Sith have stayed out of the lower city, and our strength is wasted on this stupid gang war. I tried to explain this to Breshek, but he and his Vulkers won't listen.
I need information on those Republic escape pods that crashed in the Undercity.
The escape pods? You know, I heard the Sith have been asking around the Upper City about them as well. But you don't look like you're with the Sith.
They might be spies, Gadden. They might be working for the Sith.
Calm down, Zerdra. If the Sith thought we knew anything useful, they'd have a battalion of troops kicking down our door. No, I think this off-worlder has his own agenda.
I'm not working for the Sith.
I suppose I could tell you what I know. It's not like it could do any harm to me or my gang. But it might cause problems for the Vulkers, and that's okay in my book. The Vulkers stripped those pods clean within hours after they landed. It's too bad we didn't get there first, considering what my spies reported the Vulkers found. A female Republic officer named Bastila survived the crash. We Beks don't believe in intergalactic slavery, but the Vulkers aren't so picky. They took a prisoner.
I have to get in there and rescue her. I just have to.
Normally, the Vulkers would take a captured slave and sell them for a nice profit to Davik, or an off-world slaver. But a Republic officer is no ordinary catch.
I still think Bastila is just a Republic officer. That could work to our advantage. Maybe she'll even figure out a way to escape from the Vulkar base on her own.
She's too valuable to leave with the Vulkar scum at the base. Brezhik's probably got your Republic friend hidden away somewhere safe until the big swoop race. You'll never find her.
Swoop race? What does that have to do with it?
I'm afraid your friend has become a pawn in Brezhik's game to take over the lower city. He's offered her up as the Vulkar's share of the prize in the annual swoop gang race. By putting up such a valuable prize, Brezhik hopes to win the loyalty of some of the smaller gangs. Their numbers will allow him to finally destroy me and my followers.
So how do you propose we go about rescuing Bastila, then? Well, we can't fight all the gangs.
The only hope you have of rescuing Bastila is to somehow win the big season opener of the swoop race.
But I don't even have a swoop bike. That's not fair.
I might be able to help you with this. If you'd be willing to help us. We both have something to gain here, and much to lose.
Okay, what are you proposing?
The swoop race is for the lower city gangs only. I could sponsor you as a rider for the Hidden Beks this year. If you win the race, you'll win your friend's freedom. But first, you have to do something for me. My mechanics have developed an accelerator for a swoop engine. A bike with the accelerator installed can beat any other swoop out there. But the Vulkers stole the prototype from us. They plan to use it to guarantee a victory in this year's swoop race. I need you to break into their base and steal it back.
How do I know you'll live up to your end of the bargain?
My word is my bond. Everybody in the lower city knows my reputation. Besides, you really don't have a choice. I'm your only ticket into the swoop race.
Okay, how am I supposed to get inside the Vulkar base?
Getting into the Vulkar base won't be easy. The front doors are locked tight. But I know someone who might be able to get you in the back way. Mission Veo.
Mission? Gadden, you can't be serious. She's just a kid. How is she supposed to help them with this?
Mission's explored every step of every back alley in the lower city. Plus, she knows the undercity sewers better than anyone. If anyone can get inside the Vulkar base, it's her.
Mission, that was the blue Twi'lek, right? Yeah. Oh, and she has a Wookiee friend, Zalbar. Does that mean I can get two for the price of one?
She and her Wookiee friend Zalbar are always looking to stir up a little excitement. They like to go exploring in the Undercity, despite the dangers. Your best bet is to look for her in the Undercity, but you'll need some way past the Sith guard post at the elevator.
I've got some Sith uniforms to disguise myself.
A simple disguise might have worked on the Upper City guard, but the security down here is much tougher. You'll need the proper papers to get past him. Luckily, my gang ambushed one of the Sith patrols headed down to the Undercity. They never made it, and their security papers fell into my hands. Since we're working together now, I suppose I could give them to you in exchange for your uniforms. With the security papers, you won't need a disguise anyway.
What do you want with the Sith uniforms?
I like to be prepared. Eventually, the Sith are going to try to drive us out of the Undercity. Sith disguises might give my people the edge we need in a crucial battle.
Sure, I'll trade the uniforms for the papers.
Good choice. Thanks for the uniforms. You won't need them with these security papers anyway. Now, is there anything else I can do for you?
I want to ask you some
questions. Your time would probably be better spent going after the prototype swoop engine the Vulcans stole from us. But I'll answer your questions if I can.
Is there something wrong with your eyes?
Very tactful. Are you itching for a fight or something?
How dare you? I should kill you where you stand.
Calm down, Zerdra. I'm not ashamed of what I've become. As you can see, I lost my eyes in a swoop racing crash. I rely on these artificial replacements to see now. But my blindness was not the worst consequence of my accident. My affliction was what eventually led to this war between my Bex and the Vulcans.
What do you mean?
When I lost my sight in the swoop bike accident, everyone assumed I would step down as leader of the Hidden Bex and let Brezhik, my most trusted follower, take over. But with my ocular implants, I can still see well enough to lead this gang. And I knew Brezhik wasn't ready to take over yet. Unfortunately, Brezhik didn't agree with me. In a rage, he left to join our arch rivals, the Black Vulcans. A lot of the younger gang members followed him, and soon he and his followers had taken control of the Vulcan gang.
But why start a gang war with the Bex? That doesn't make sense to me.
Brezhik is a proud man. My decision was a public humiliation for him. Maybe if I had stepped down, this gang war could have been avoided.
Don't fool yourself, Gadden. Brezhik wants to control the lower city gangs. If you'd stepped down, he'd have led the Bex against the Vulcans. He wanted this war, one way or another.
I know you're right, Zerdra. Brezhik won't rest until I am dead and the Bex are no more. But it's hard to accept the truth of his betrayal.
Okay, I'm gonna ask him something.
Your time would probably...
You said you were having problems with the Sith.
A foreign army invades Terrace, declares martial. If the Sith ever moved in down here...
Don't fool yourself.
But so far...
Okay.
Your time would probably...
Let's see, why are Brezhik and the Vulcans at war with you? We kind of already did that. Is there any way off the planet?
Not while the Sith quarantine is in place. Even the fastest smuggler ships can't break the blockade of the fleet surrounding the planet without the proper launch codes. Any ship leaving the Terrace atmosphere without the proper codes would be instantly disintegrated by blaster cannons fired by the Sith fleet's automated targeting systems.
Okay. Well, I'll be going for now.
Feel free to come back anytime. We're not like those Vulcan savages. Strangers are welcome in the Beck base.
Okay. Well, guys, I think I'm then going to call it an episode. If you liked, please like the video. If you want to subscribe, please subscribe. I hope to have my Patreon page up by the time this video goes up. So if you want to visit there, I would really appreciate it. If you were to give $1 a month, I would really, really appreciate that. If not, don't worry about it. Let's see. What else is there? I'm hoping to get to Dantooine soon. So once I get there, I'm probably going to start up a second series on Star Wars Republic Commando. So that one's a little bit more first-person shooter than RPG. So if you want to see that, check out, pay attention on my channel, because it'll be coming soon. I think that's it. Stay safe out there, guys, and good luck, and may the Force be with you.